Hello everyone, Ken here. Today I'm showing you how to scrape Twitter data using Python and the Twitter Scraper module. So on my screen is the Twitter Scraper documentation. It is also in the description below. As you can see, you can do it from the command line, but I prefer to do it from the notebook. It allows me to read it in directly into a data frame and allows me to manipulate it from there. To get started, we install it. Pip install Twitter Scraper. I've obviously already downloaded it, so all the requirements are met here. Now I'm going to open up Spider, which is my IDE of choice for data science. So from Twitter Scraper, import query tweets. Now we're also going to import datetime, because we want to set a date range for the tweets. And we're going to import pandas, because we want to turn this into a data frame after we're done. So the first thing we're going to do is query tweets takes a couple parameters. The first one, and a relevant one to us, is begin date is equal to So I want to query something recent. I'm going to do the Notre Dame fire that happened very recently. That'll be a good example to show us something that is relevant and a lot of the information associated with that on Twitter. We'll also do an end date. We're going to do tomorrow. Today is the 17th for me. And that's because it just takes all of yesterday's, today's data as well. And that's relevant if you just want to do a time window. For example, in one of my previous videos, I did the timing around a movie premiere. We can also put in a limit. So let's say this is a really, really popular topic. We can set a limit of 1,000 or so. So we don't go crazy. We don't have millions and millions of tweets that would take forever to download. Now we can also set a language. So lang equals English in this case. If we're doing the Notre Dame fire, there's gonna be a lot of French tweets, I would expect. So we'd wanna filter those out so it's understandable for me mainly. If we wanted to just look at one person's tweets, we could also just query them. We would set the user is equal to, let's just say, real Trump. If you wanted to hear his wacky comments on the Notre Dame fire, you'd be able to type that in and filter specifically for that. Now for the real magic here, we just query tweets. So, and we put in our parameters. Right here we're asking for Notre Dame fire, which is our key component that we're gonna query. You can also put hashtags, anything relevant that you would like there. We do begin date equals begin date, end date equals end date. We're gonna set the limit equal to limit, and lang is equal to lang. So we can load all of this in. And this should take just a couple minutes. If you're doing anything over 10, 100,000, it can take up to, 20, 30 minutes to actually run. The way they do this is they just have, from my understanding, a bunch of threads hitting Twitter. So it depends fairly heavily on the processing power of your computer if you want to increase the speed or not. So looks like we got 1,020, which is pretty close to our limit, so I can't complain too much. It isn't super exact just because of, I guess, the structure of the back end there. Now we want to make this relevant to us. As you can see, the tweets here are just in tweet objects that don't really mean a ton to us yet. So let's transform this into a data frame. So data frame is equal to frame, and then we want to do All right, so after doing that, we have all of our Twitter data. We have the username. We have the number of likes, replies, etc. You can filter by that if you want, or you can order by it, etc. And we also have all of the tweets. As you can see, there's a ton of duplicates, so that's something that I like to remove duplicates of. A lot of them are news related. We also have the URL and the actual username of the person who posted these tweets. You can do a lot of really interesting stuff with this. I've done a sentiment analysis in the past on Captain Marvel, the movie premiere, and you can see that above. You can also combine it all, make a word cloud related to the event or the topic that you're covering. And there's plenty of other text-based analysis that you can do with this information. This is a great tool. It's fast, easy, and free, and I highly recommend that you use it. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, please like. If you want to see more content like this, please subscribe. Have a great one.